In Berlin was, although we were having great fun and the city is just amazing, full of culture and art and stuff, just the album was starting to become a little bit techno and dark.
Mm-hmm.
And we just didn't want to make a techno album. We felt that there was a lot of that on radio, a lot of kind of DJs becoming really popular, and we really wanted to go back on the road and play instruments and tour, because we've been touring for 3 years on the first record and we really got to play well and learn how to play our instruments better. So we wanted to go back on the road and play kind of heavy,
mm-hmm,
our guitars and drums and have that experience for a year. And with techno music, it's difficult to do that because it's kind of controlled. So we took our studio to Spain, and being kind of in a southern, warmer climate, everybody's like congas and drums and percussion and rhythm. It's really important. So we got to write songs like Hang It Up, Hit Me Down Sonny, that had a different kind of feel to what Berlin was giving us.
We wanted to find a reason to write the second album. We weren't feeling really inspired. We didn't feel like we had anything to say. And then when we thought about writing an album where we consciously made every song an experiment and something, let's try this and let's TLC and then we're going to get inspired by Beastie Boys, then Nancy Sinatra, it just made us feel so free and made us feel much more comfortable writing, and we felt like we had a bit of fire in our stomachs. So I actually think it worked in the favour of the album, really. And I think that it's almost like it reflects popular culture at the minute, where it jumps from one thing to the other. We're not saying it's the best way to make an album, but we found it to be an interesting way.
I mean, there was a few tracks from many albums that we got fascinated by. Fleetwood Mac was another band that we were picking tracks of. Not the whole thing about Fleetwood Mac, and equally not the whole thing about the Beastie Boys, but we were obviously getting fixated by the way, for example, in hip-hop culture, the music, for decades, it's been able to take different genres of music like funk, soul, classic, if you want, pop, and bring it in with beat and then rap, and no one complains about it. If you take like a modern rock band and they were to take those influences, I think a lot of their fans would be really disappointed. But, you know, hip-hop's allowed to do that. And I think we tried to take that approach to this album where we weren't boxed in, we could do anything we want. We started the band just Katie on guitar and drums when we first started out, so everything kind of always evolves around us doing it in a studio live. So even though the recordings are embellished and we experiment in the studio, we always end up hitting a wall. We don't like something, the arrangement's not right, and we go straight into the live performance, and that's when we find out what's wrong with it, and then go back in the studio, and we keep doing that. And then obviously we use loop pedals with our feet, so we have these samplers, and then we kind of take sounds from the recording and percussion and keyboard sounds, we put them on our feet, and then we play drums and guitars, and we keep rehearsing. We play like an hour and 15 minutes, just quite a load of energy. You know, the hits on the first album, all the high energy songs of the second album, we swap instruments all the time, like on Hands, one of our tracks that's not, it's only on one part of the album, of the second album, on the deluxe version. We go on to DJ, and we build it up on the DJ, and then we jump on guitar and drums and then power it out. So there's a real kind of like schizophrenic attitude going on stage.
We look forward to coming back and we want some more Fritz. I was so upset today. We got here and it was 2:30, so we just missed lunch, so I couldn't have more Fritz.
Oh, it's a problem?
It's a tough life, you know? It's hard. My life's so difficult.
Yeah, I understand.